In this video, we're going to go over, now that you have populated your Excel template, how to import it back into your Business Central environment. The objectives here are going to be importing an Excel file with no errors. So we're going to look at what I would call sort of the sunny day. Everything is great. And then we're going to look at error management handling, which is going to be the more common scenario, especially when you're dealing with larger tables and more fields and more data. When you import into Business Central, you can get errors because it is validating the data if you've set it up to do so. So there may be some additional scrubbing that needs to get done before you can actually put it into your database and see the data. So we have saved our Excel file. We have no errors. So I'm going to go ahead and I am going to search Config Worksheet. I need to find the customer and the package code that I used in my Excel file. So that's really important, because if my Excel file has three columns and three fields, I need to make sure that the system knows where that data needs to land and what fields it needs to interact with. If I were to, example, use the customer row here that has a different package code, well, that could have different filter criteria. That could have different fields included. So again, I'm opening up my risk that I'm interacting with the wrong fields and that data is getting put where it shouldn't be, or I've got a lot of different errors to deal with. So your first validation is, am I dealing with the right table? Am I dealing with the right package? Under Prepare, under Excel, I am going to import from template. It's asking me if I want to import. I will say yes. And here is where I can either click to find the Excel file from my local drive somewhere, or I can drag and drop. So I'm going to choose to drag and drop it, but I am going to drag and drop an open file. So I go ahead. Most often when I see this error, it is because you still have the file open. So you cannot import an open file. So all you would do is look for your open Excel file and go ahead and close it. I'm going to go ahead and try again. So the system is confirming this is the package code. This is the table ID. I can go ahead and say import if I'm good with this. Now what you'll notice over here is that the number of package records has increased. My number of database records was 5. It's still 5, so that's good. And I included 3 fields. So what's important to note here is that when I do my import, I am not importing to the table directly. I'm importing first to what's called a package. It's doing data checking, data validation. It's going to let me know if it's found any errors. And then once I've done that, I can apply the data and that will move it from the package to the table. So in this case, I can see in the second row that the number of errors is 0. So this means that I don't have any issues with my data that is found currently. We'll talk about package errors in a moment in more detail. Again, I always use this as a bit of a sanity check as well. So number of database records, I'm only modifying existing data. So again, I had 5 before, I have 5 now, all is checking out. I had spoken earlier about a scenario where I had a customer who wanted to change their IDs on some records. So again, they just updated the number field and then imported, which would have made, you know, 5, 10, because again, it was the primary key, it added the records. So what I always like to do is just look at my number of records and validate, is that the right number? Does that make sense? And then again, number of fields included. This is again just an opportunity to make sure that if I think I have 3 columns, the system doesn't think I have 10. This lets me know the number of fields that were available to be updated. In this case, it's 127. If everything checks out, I can go under Home and I can say Apply Data. So the system is telling me, great, I didn't find any errors. I didn't add anything new that wasn't there before, and 5 records were modified. So just as a note, you will, even if you had lines in your package file that you didn't change the salesperson code, let's say in this example, the system still indicates 5 records modified because, again, it looks at the fields and the data in your Excel sheet. It essentially removes the data that's in the system and adds whatever it read based on the columns and the rows inside of your Excel sheet. So it could very well take the data out and replace it with the same data, or it could be new data like it was in this case, replacing the JO to the HR. So as I can see now, there's nothing left in my package. Naturally, I don't have any errors. And if I want, I can drill into my database records now. And if I look, I can see that my salesperson code has updated. You can't drill down into the database records on all of the tables, but you can lots of different tables. So if you get a prompt saying you can't drill down, you can always search for the table that you expected to see the updates on and look at it just from the page itself. And I do recommend always going in and spot checking your data to validate that you don't see anything weird like descriptions or name fields that weren't populated or things like that if there was any kind of an issue with the import. Again, just sort of a best practice. So now let's talk about error management. Let's talk about what happens when a file has an error and how to do the troubleshooting of those errors. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to open up my Excel customer update file again. And I'm going to intentionally insert a bunch of errors. All right, I'm also going to put in and I'm going to import my bad file. So again, I'm highlighting the table in the package. I'm going to go under Prepare, Excel, Import. And I'm going to drag my file in. So I want to draw your attention to the package errors. You'll notice that it imported, but it didn't immediately catch the errors. This can happen. It can happen because it doesn't check every single scenario, every single field right out of the gate. It does just check for some of the obvious stuff. And it means that once you apply, you may find that then the errors populate. You may also find that you'll fix your package errors. You'll clean everything up, you'll apply the data, and then you'll find you get a new set of errors that come up. Because again, if you're dealing with something like the customer table, the item table, it will look, it finds an error, it stops processing that record. Once you fix the offending data and you go to apply again, then it will continue to check the rest of the fields as soon as it hits another error. So just so you know, it is normal, it is part of the process to sometimes have to apply the data over and over and over and fix errors sort of in a loop. So here I'm going to go to home and I'm going to say apply data. So now it's taking everything out of the package. So you'll see here that 3 errors were found, 1 record was inserted, and 0 records were modified. So the other thing you may or may not have noticed is that my database records went from 5 to 6. So again, I had shown you when I made an error where I changed the primary key. So very important to be very careful and not do that. So now I'm going to drill in and look at my package errors. And here I can see the three offending records. I'm going to click on Show Error, and this lets me know that I've indicated in my sales person code column of my customer template that it cannot be found in the related salesperson purchaser table. So I can't add Helen Ray to my template unless Helen Ray exists inside of my database in that table. So what I am able to do is I could search inside of my BC and I can then see, well, what are my options? And if I want, I can change this to a list view. So I have to use BC, EH, HR, JO, LT. I have to use one of the codes that exists there because it's a code 20 field. So that's the code it's looking for. So I can't use the name. So even though Helen, or this is Helena actually, Helena Ray, if that name existed, it wouldn't matter. It needs to be the code. So what I can do, my first option, would be to go back to the Excel file, update the Helen Ray to HR, and re-import again. So let's do that first. So I'm going to open up my Excel template, and I'm going to change this first one to HR. I'm going to save that. I'm going to close that. I'm going to re-import that. So I'm going to go ahead again now that I've fixed that one record, and I'm going to import. Again, we're going to overwrite, so it's just letting us know those records are going to be overwritten. So now I can see that I've got a quantity of 5. So I've got the HR salesperson code. And then again, these two other errors that we'll address. So I'm going to say OK. And apply. So now I only found 2 errors. Nothing new was inserted. Nothing else was modified. So what's my other option? My other option would be to, in this configuration package records page, I could just change the salesperson code field directly. Once I tab off, it's come off of my list. I could say okay, and I could apply the data. So now I can see that I only have 1 record left in the package that has an error. So again, I'm going to open up. And here, Cheryl, let's say Cruz, doesn't exist. She's not in my template. I don't have a CX salesperson code, so I know that wasn't the issue. So my last option would be to add the data that I need. And it could be a combination of both adding it to a related table and then updating the package record here as an example. So what I could do is navigate to, in this case, my salespeople table. I'm going to click on new to add the record that I need. I could add all the rest of the information. I could do that later. And then here, close the page, apply the data. 1 record's modified, so now nothing is left there. So as we could see, you have the opportunity to fix the Excel sheet and re-import. So if you have a large list of customers, you've made the mistake on lots of records, obviously to use the find and replace function in Excel is really handy and makes a lot of sense. The second option would be to open up the package errors page and directly fix in the list page the issue that you had. Again, if it's only a few records, if you know that's probably the only mistake that was made because you've got a limited column set, makes sense to do it that way. And then thirdly, it could be that, you know, there was a new salesperson that was added. They're on lots of records. You haven't added them to your salespeople table as the prerequisite, so you go ahead and do that. And then you could just apply the data from there. The last thing that's sort of a bonus is in the config package, if you were to open that up, you can create missing codes as another option. Note that it will only create the code record. So if we open up and we go to our fields from within the package, so under table, we go to fields, there's this create missing codes. So what that would have done is, let's say, for example, I added in my import a new salesperson. Let's say that the initial was JC, but it didn't exist in my salesperson table. I could say create missing code. Let's go ahead and actually run through that scenario. So again, I'm going to open up my Excel spreadsheet one more time. And I'm going to add JC as a salesperson code. And here, I'll just make this HR and this CX. So one thing to note is that if you change the Excel file data directly in BC and you import later, you may bring up the errors again. So that's something to also consider when you decide how to manage your errors. So now what I'm going to do is within the fields, I'm going to look for salespeople and I'm going to say create missing codes. So what this will do is it's just going to create the code field for anything that it cannot find. Let's take a look. JC does not exist. So what I'm going to do, and I can do this from within the package, or I can do it the same way I'd been doing it before. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to import my data. Five, six, everything looks the way that it was. I'm going to go ahead and apply. So now one record was modified. I wasn't given an error, but I didn't have that salesperson code exist. So what the system did for me is it just created the very, very basic card. So here it created the JC code that it needed to successfully import. And now what I would need to do as a user is go and backfill the data, like the name, like the title, phone number, email, whatever it is that I need to complete the record, but the system created enough to get it by. So that is an option, but again, you want to make sure that you go back and you backfill the data.